This is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. I have a very exciting episode for you today. I'm up on the roof, and I'm on the roof of my house here, and in the front you can see all my raised beds. I have a total of like 14 raised beds throughout my front yard over on this side, and then some over on the other side of the yard as well. And this is what I call an urban homestead. But if Jules Dervais has his way, this video actually might get taken down because he's attempting to trademark and patent the term urban homestead, urban homesteading, and some other terms that we're gonna talk about in a second once we get off the roof. But anyways, I actually got into what I call urban homesteading, or growing my own food at home. Actually, one of the reasons was because of him. I saw his videos, saw his family's videos on YouTube, and was really inspired and wanted to then desire and had the desire to grow my own food in my front yard. The unfortunate thing is I saw how what he was doing, but he had no plans or any basically way on showing you or teaching you how to do it. So I went on my own quest, basically learning as I went, or learning as I grow, as I like to say, to figure out how to basically build the raised beds, how to take out my lawn, how to do cardboard sheet mulching, how to put the irrigation in, how to plant everything, what to plant at what times of the year. And the lucky thing is I have documented that for everybody to see on YouTube, and I have now over 350 videos that document from building what you see here that's in my front yard. And you can see some of the neighbors' houses. I mean, they just have regular lawns and cars, and I mean, everybody has a lot except me. I'm growing 90 to 95% of my vegetables year round here in Northern California, and you could do it too. And hopefully this video won't get taken down because I am using a potentially trademarked term, urban homestead. So what today's episode is gonna be about is we're just gonna talk more about trademarks and patents and what's going on right now. I mean, this all happened within the last week, and I just learned about it this morning, and I was outraged and figured I'd make a video for everybody, you know, to learn this knowledge and then to basically get in an uproar about this, because I feel this is actually not right to, you know, patent the term urban homestead. And I also feel it's not right to patent things like life, like seeds should not be patented either. So let's get off the roof before I fall over. It's a little bit windy today, and we're gonna sit down, talk more about this situation that's going on, and I'm gonna share my opinions and views with you. So now I'm sitting where my front lawn used to be, and I'm proud to say that I am an urban homesteader, growing 90 to 95% of my vegetables that I eat actually on a year-round basis. So actually behind me is my lettuce bed. Have over 100 lettuce plants in here. I do what's called sustainable harvesting. I harvest one leaf off like many plants to get a salad. Behind me there I have the tree collards, perennial tree collards. I love the tree collards. Be sure to check my other videos on tree collards and bok choy and radishes. Got all kinds of stuff growing here in my urban homestead. That being said, if Jules Dervais has his way, I might not be able to call this an urban homestead anymore unless I credit him. So basically, I was really inspired when I saw the Dervais originally and saw what they're doing with their land in Pasadena and their homestead and growing food. I thought, you know, I should do it too. And like I said earlier, you know, they showed what they were doing, but they didn't exactly show how to do it. So I've actually been video blogging to share my experiences on how to build the beds, how to plant the beds, what to grow, and then I travel and show other people growing so that people could just learn more about growing food and how to do it, because we're not taught how to do it. So when I was down in Southern California about a year or so ago, you know, I actually emailed the Dervais family to see if I could come by, because, you know, they were like my idols, and I idolized these people for doing what they're doing and sharing it with the world. And I actually emailed them for an interview, and I was basically denied an interview. I got an email like from a publicist or somebody that basically said, you know, we just don't give interviews to anybody and this and that, and just basically pawned me off. So I wasn't too happy about that, but I was like, you know, they're just probably really busy, and, you know, I probably wouldn't like visitors here. Although if any, you know, news media or anybody wants to come by here, you know, I'm always available to, you know, basically give a tour and show what I'm doing. Obviously, I'm not here to let anybody in the public come and, you know, give a tour. That's why I have the videos for. But, you know, I'm open to basically sharing what I'm doing with others because it's such a strong message that needs to get out to people. So my question is, you know, why are they doing this? Why are they sending these letters to, this letter is actually to UrbanHomesteadX.com. They sent a letter that basically says, unauthorized use of Dervais Institute trademarks and copyrights. And basically it says in this letter that if you use the words urban homestead, urban homesteading, path to freedom, grow the future, homegrown revolution, freedom gardens, or little homestead in the city, and that one's actually pending, then you must give credit to Dervais because it is their material. And I guess the proper way it says in this letter is to only use small sample of our work in any single instance. Copy the portion used in its entirety. Do not paraphrase or extract portions of images or paragraphs. Make it clear by using quotation marks or different font, size, or color that the Dervais material referenced are from another source. Include a prominent link or reference to the original source of the content used on the Dervais website. So basically, I'm feeling that, you know, Mr. Dervais has an issue. And his issue is either one or two things. Number one, he wants notoriety or he wants to feel significant. And he's not feeling significant now because there's a lot more people doing urban homesteads than when he started. He was like the only one, you know, doing it like he was doing it. But now there's so many people doing this and he wants to feel important, get some recognition for what he's doing. And I agree that he should get some recognition. But going about it by sending, you know, notices to other bloggers and other people that are on a similar mission to educate people about growing food. And there's no other thing that's more powerful on this earth that we should be all doing is teaching people how to grow food and eat their own food that they are growing. I mean, that's a really powerful message. And now he's trying to basically squelch out people from having this voice, or at least if they do, they have to use a different terminology. And I don't think that's really right. So definitely, if he wants some more recognition and more significance, you know what? He should get out there more and make more videos, show people what he's doing, and just get out there and do the right thing. He shouldn't be sending around nasty letters to get people to actually. He's also actually had Google take down links to different websites and actually Facebook deleted, you know, web pages with comments about, you know, a certain book on urban homesteading and the such. In my opinion, that's just not cool. The other reason maybe why he's doing this is because it all comes down to one thing here in America, unfortunately, and in many other countries in the world. Comes down to the green stuff, and I don't mean the tree collards behind me, I mean the money. And that's really sad, you know. I mean, you would think the last person that would be worried about making money and commercializing urban homestead would be Mr. Dervais. And so I think that's really sad that he actually is doing this. I really hope and pray that he's going to just rescind this and come back and say, you know, this was my error, I made a mistake, I apologize for doing all this, and let's just start fresh. What's happening so far is that he came out with this letter, sent it around, pissed a lot of people off, the people are basically giving him a backlash, and then basically he's getting on the defensive. Like, no, I'm standing firm on this. So anyways, this is his letter that he sent out to people, kind of like a nasty letter. And then I'm happy that the EFF, or Electronic Frontier Foundation, is getting involved. They actually fight for the rights of, for the First Amendment, basically. And basically they wrote him a letter talking about urban homesteading and that it's been used, widely adopted for many years to describe a social movement that promotes self-sufficient, sustainable living in cities during, like, in the 1970s. So long before he says, and he claims the usage, because he used the term in, let's see, what year did he start using it? In the 2000s, it says, your use of services from 2005 to 2010. So he only started using it in 2005. He's claiming that, like, he owns it. I mean, I can see how he owns some of his other terms, maybe Path to Freedom and some of the other things, but I really disagree with that. He owns the term urban homesteading. And so this video is to basically do a couple things. Number one, it's to let all my viewers know about this, because I think this is a great injustice, and I think what my viewers should do are two things. Number one, they should go to his website, Jules Dervais' website, and the Dervais Institute, and email them and let them know, hey man, what you're doing is not right. Try to put some pressure on him to, rescind all this stuff because it's just not cool. And it's just like, there shouldn't be waves in this urban homesteading movement. I mean, it's like, to me, when it comes down to this kind of stuff, it's like about government and people meddling and, you know, what just people shouldn't meddle in, like patenting genes, for example, you know, to patent genes so you could sell seeds. And now you have the exclusive on that seed. Well, much like, I don't think we should be patenting life. You know, we shouldn't be patenting common terms like urban homesteading. I mean, that could, the definition varies far and widely. I mean, here are just some other examples. The government, the HUD, or the U.S. government actually uses urban homesteading program in its work, you know, in its name for a booklet and a program they actually have running that they've probably run for many years. Another thing, actually, Urban Homesteading Assistance Board in New York City. They've been around since at least, you know, for over 30 years. They've been basically helping transform renters into homeowners who collectively own and democratically govern true housing cooperatives that will remain affordable in perpetuity to people of modest means. So, I mean, urban homesteading term has been used widely far before Mr. DeVays has, you know, patented or copyrighted, whatever he wants to say, his term and how he's using it. So I would really encourage him to, you know, go out and seek some significance or some money in some other ways and maybe forget about this thing. So what else can you do as a viewer of my video? Well, you know, this is good for the urban homesteading movement because it's creating some controversy, and people like controversy, unfortunately. So more people are learning about this. There's definitely a Facebook page that everybody should get involved with. I'll have a link below. Click on that and like it. And, you know, get this more out to more people so that more people are aware of what's going on. Because, you know, knowledge is power. And that's one of the reasons why I have my show, to teach about all the different crazy things that go on in the garden, how to grow in my area and my climate and also other climates. And that's just why I do what I do, because knowledge is power, and I'm here to share the knowledge, not to constrict it. And so if I ever get into some crazy thing about trademarking or patenting stuff, you know, somebody just write me and let me know, and I'll, you know, I won't do it, because, you know, I'm not about like that kind of stuff. It's just not me. And you would think somebody into urban homesteading is just not rooted in that whole societal thing about the money and about all this kind of stuff. You know, it's just not cool. So one of the things I want every viewer that watches this video to do is to share the knowledge about urban homesteading with a friend, a neighbor, a wife, a daughter, a son, whoever you haven't talked about it before, to let people know that they should start to grow their own food. We could make lemonade out of lemons with this situation. So think about the positive, think how this could benefit everybody, and don't think about, you know, how it's, oh, it's so terrible, you know. So it's only gonna be a good thing. It's gonna blow over. And once again, I'll still be doing my videos, although if some of them get taken down off YouTube, that's gonna suck. But anyways, I'm gonna keep going for it, and I'll just have to change my terminology, or of course respect him and give him credit if in fact legally it does prove to go through. In any case, hope you've learned more about this situation that's going on in the urban homesteading world. Once again, this is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com, coming at you from my urban homestead here in Northern California. So be sure to check my other videos so that you can learn how to grow food too at your own personal urban homestead.